Welkom everybody. Welcome at this online event about LEAK organized by Beo Zaden. My name is René Ballast. I work as a crop manager for Beo in Eastern Europe. The program today will be about the added value of hybrid varieties. We made an interesting program together with a group of colleagues. I will start with the opening and an introduction to tell something about the market of LEAK worldwide. Then my colleague Peter Willems, our LEAK breeder within Beo, will tell something about breeding and production, and with the focus on selection criteria and the added value of hybrids compared to open pollinated varieties, and some developments within our breeding program. After that, we will have a look at two videos. One will be about plant raising of LEAK plants, and the other one will be about cultivation of LEAK in the Netherlands. After that, my colleague Danielle Bruin will give a presentation about LEAK and further in the chain as an end product. As a start, questions can be asked by using the chat. The webinar will be also become available online, so if you would like to see it one more time afterwards, it will be possible. When you have questions left after the webinar, of course, don't hesitate to contact one of your local Beo representatives or to ask the question to one of us. First, about the LEAK world market, we will highlight a few of the most important markets of LEAK. We'll start with the USA, where approximately 1,350 hectares of LEAK is produced. Argentina, around 1,500 hectares. In Brazil, around 1,900 hectares. Then we go to Europe. Western Europe is a very big market for LEAK production, with approximately 23,000 hectares of LEAK. Southeast Europe produces around 800 hectares. Then Eastern Europe is a crop in development, where now approximately 650 hectares is produced, but this is growing. And then Australia and New Zealand, stable markets with 250 hectares in Australia and around 200 hectares in New Zealand. We will now have a look at the markets to see talk about the developments. First, the LEAK market in the USA. The LEAK market is around 150 hectares in the USA, which is 50% grown with hybrids and 50% with open pollinated varieties. The variety of the market is stable in acreage, and the market is divided in two areas. There's a year-round production in the southwest of the USA, and in the northeast and northwest there's seasonal production, so from spring to autumn plantings. The USA exports also mainly to the surrounding countries, and then some developments about the market in the USA. There's a transition going on from OP to hybrid. Next to that, there's an increase in packet trade, so more interest from hobby and semi-professional growers. Also, we see an increase in organic production in the USA. And we see in more markets, there's also a shortage of labor, what will come back also later on in the presentations. Then the LEAK market in South America, it's a big market. 3,400 hectares, mainly grown by smaller semi and semi-professional growers. It's spread all over the countries, and is stable in acreage. Then the leek market in Western Europe. It's a market of 23,000 hectares, which is divided in 20,000 hectares of fresh market and 3,000 hectares of industry. Also here we see that the market in general is stable. It's a very big international market. Leek plants are mainly raised by specialized plant raisers. The first plants are produced in Morocco and imported in Europe. Then the plants are grown in Portugal, then spread it all over Europe, and then mostly in Northern Europe, afterwards produced by plant raisers. Then the market in UK, it is different than the other countries, because here the main market is direct sowing, and this is the main difference between UK and the other countries in Western Europe. Some developments. Also in Western Europe, we see an increase in organic production. We see all over the countries around 5% of the market is organic, but this is growing. Also here, more and more F1s, hybrids are growing compared to OPs. Yeah, the main market in Western Europe is already used by hybrid varieties. Some other developments. In some countries, there are more pre-packed leeks without the leaves sold into the market. In other markets, the sales by pieces is increasing and more focus on the best quality leeks. Later on, this will come back also in the presentation of Daniela. Then the leek market in Southeast and Eastern Europe. In general, we see that the market is growing. Leek is introduced in new markets, like in Russia, in Belarus, where leek was not consumed on big scale yet. There's a trend to year-round supply to supermarkets and to markets. In general, in Eastern Europe, we see a trend that the sales of vegetables are more done through supermarkets instead of the bazaars and the open markets that were used a lot before. And then the market in Southeast Europe, where from history the Bulgarian giant type was very popular. This market of the Bulgarian giant is stable, but we see an increase also in the blue-green types, which are also growing in Western Europe. Develops in general developments in general in this market. We see that the market becomes more professional, so the more growers turn from open pollinated varieties into hybrids. The sales through supermarkets is increasing, and also here we see the shortage of labor is becoming a bigger and bigger problem. And a few words about the market in Australia and New Zealand. There's a total market of 450 hectares. The market is really stable. In Australia, this acreage is grown by a few professional growers with a bigger acreage. And in New Zealand, there are several smaller professional and semi-professional growers. Then we will continue with the next presentation from Peter Willems. Peter Willems is our breeder of leek within Beozaden. Peter will tell us more about the breeding program. The floor is yours, Peter.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Peter Willems, leek breeder of Beozaden. And I would like to tell you about breeding leeks with Bijo. In other words, how to make a hybrid. So the content of my talk is, first I want to show you the breeding department and who is helping us with breeding. And then some features of LEAG, like the gene center, family and types. And then I want to tell you something about hybrids versus OPs. And then breeding LEAGs, how to make a hybrid, how we test the hybrid, and the selection items we select on in breeding. And then some developments where we are working on, like an overwintering type, and Lincoln hybrid. CMS is a male's sterile system, and markers. So first, the breeding department. The breeder is me, Peter Willems. I have an assistant, Will Grubber, here on the right with the leeks in his hand in a raincoat. And I have three breeding assistants, Marcel, Malouk, and Katja. And we got a lot of help of the research department, for example. They do the diseases, they do the markers, and the tissue culture. Also, we get help of the sales department for the trials and market information. And we get the help of the production department. They do the trials outside near the station and take care of the glasshouse and the seed productions. Features of LEAG. The gene center is the Mediterranean, so all the countries around the Mediterranean Sea, like Egypt, Greece, France, Croatia, and there you can find wild relatives of LEAG, still at the moment. The genus is Allium. Onion, garlic, and bunching onion belong to that genus. And those crops have some similarities, like vegetative propagation and diseases like thrips, rust, and alternaria. LEAG is tetraploid. That means that the chromosomes are in fourfold, and that makes breeding quite complex. Most crops are diploid. LEAG is open pollinated and prefers cross-pollination. LEAG suffers a lot from inbreeding depression. When you make an inbred, the vitality will be halved, will be 50%. LEAG is biannual. The first year it will grow vegetative, and the second year you get a flower. And that inbreeding, it's difficult because it's very slow. You need 2 years to get a flower. First there were only OPs, and then we get the hybrids, and you need a system for that, and therefore we use genetic male sterility. I will explain that later. And LEAG is grown over more than 4,000 years, so it's a quite an old crop and is adapted to many climates. So types of LEAG, we have for example, we have a Swiss giant. Examples of that are Lancia and Columbus. You see the pictures of that. And that is more a very fast growing leeks with a pale green color. Also, you have the blue-green autumn, like Lancelot and Ginkga. They are more blue and they need more growing days. Then you have the blue-green winter, like Forest and Banded. They are even a better color, more blue color, I must say, and a shorter shank, and they can stand some cold, some freezing. And the special type is the Bulgarian giant, here on the left, the picture. Example is Lincoln. It's a really long, very long shank and a green color. That are the types. So why should you use a hybrid? A hybrid is high yielding. That's because it's a crossing between two lines, and it's more heterosis. You have more heterosis. A hybrid is more uniform. For example, here, a picture of Walker is a hybrid. And you see that all the shank lengths are the same, and the size is also the same. On the right, you have a picture of Lincoln, and you see some smaller plants, and there's some variation in the shank length. It's another advantage is that you can plan your cropping. For example, when you plant a hybrid in June, you know you will harvest it in October. The cleaning is also much better, also due to the uniformity. The disease resistance is better. It's easier to breed in a disease in a hybrid. That's because a hybrid is a crossing between two lines. And when one line, for example, it has some Alternaria resistance, another line has some Phytophthora resistance, in a combination, in the hybrid, it's Alternaria resistant and Phytophthora resistant. And hybrid is also easier to harvest by machine, also due to the uniformity, but also due to the plant type, the erectness of the leaves. And the hybrid is genetic stable. An OP you have to maintain, and you have to select always for the true type. How to make a hybrid in leek? It's not easy. You need a male sterile line. Here's a picture on the left, and you see that there are no pollen on the flowers. On the right, you see a picture of a male fertile line, and you see pollen. So in a seed production, the pollen will go to the male sterile line, and you can harvest the hybrid on the mother line, on the male sterile line. It's a genetic male sterility we use, and how do we get such a male sterile line? It's quite easy. You make an F2 out of a hybrid, and in that F2, you have to select the steriles, and one out of 36 are sterile. Seed production, in breeding, we use plastic bags, for example, here on the left. Just to make an inbred, we use small isolations in the glasshouse and tunnels. On the larger scales, for making a hybrid, commercial hybrid, we use outside in Italy, glasshouses in the UK and Holland, and also tunnels in France. For various markets, you need various leeks. Not only the season, summer, autumn, winter, and overwinter, you have to make varieties with all the criteria. For example, for a summer variety, you need a bolting resistance. But you all have also the demands of customers. For example, the industry would like to have very long leeks, so they can put them all into the freezer. But for example, a supermarket like the Albert Heijn, they like short leeks, 38 centimeters long, a thickness of 3 to 4 centimeters, and a flag or leaf of just 5 centimeters. And for example, the French and Belgium market wants 20 centimeters of white shank, then 4 or 5 centimeters transition, the green part, and then a blue-green color. So every market wants different leeks. So where do we select on? First, we select on the type, and we select mostly for the upright type, like this. It's easier to harvest by machine. On the right picture is a wider type. It must be closed, so no splitting on the shank, no cracking, no delamination. There's a picture of delamination. It's where the leaves are splitting on the cut. The color for most markets, as blue as possible, green-blue as possible. it must be easy to harvest by machines. And here I have two pictures. Also, for example, the picture above on the right, it's a caterpillar. It's taken in France, and they have very heavy soils, and they harvest the leeks like that. And no bolting, especially for the summer varieties. Then selection on the shank, a high yield, of course. Most growers get paid by kilogram. The peeling, the cleaning is most important because a lot of labor is involved, and labor is expensive. The uniformity, all plants must grow to a normal good leek. The length, depending on the market, of course. Also the diameter. And the white green part, I just told you, the French market wants a short transition, like biker over here. On the right, you have climber, and the green part on the shank is much longer. And France and Belgium don't like that. The shank must be smooth, no bulb, and a good root system, like here on the picture. Below, you see a picture where it isn't a good root system, and the roots are growing up into the shank. Then we select also on pests, especially trips. The plant protection is getting less and less, and by selecting on that item, we try to make more tolerant varieties like Darter and Climber and Bowler. Also, we select on onion fly and leek moth. Then we also select on fungal diseases like rust. Rust you see everywhere, all over the world. I think is number one on diseases on fungi. Also, we select on purple blotch here on the picture, the blue of the purple spots on the leaves. White tip is more a winter fungi. After some frost, you can have Phytophthora, and Fusarium and Colletotrichum also in the picture. Also, we select on Pseudomonas syringae, a picture of this. You have dropouts of plants, and you can't spray it against it. So the variety must be resistant. Pseudomonas fluorescens is a secondary disease. It gets, for example, after a fungi like Colletotrichum. Then the viruses. Here on the right, you see a picture of leek yellow stripe virus is transmitted by aphids. And also we have iris yellow spot virus transmitted by trips. And also therefore we are looking for resistance. So testing a hybrid. We make around 600 new crossings, new hybrids every year. After discarding the bad mother and father lines, we have around 250 new hybrids. We put them in four trials, one on sandy soil, one on clay soil, one a disease trial without spraying, and one direct drilled. And when we find good varieties, we put them in the second and third year in 27 trials in Europe. In that trials, we have around 45 new hybrids. In the fourth year, when we find a good variety, we make an experimental, seed production will start, and we put it again in those 27 trials in Europe. In the fifth and sixth year, sales will test the experimental on a larger scale with growers. And if it's still a good variety in the seventh and eighth year, it gets a BJ number, and it will be tested further, and the introduction will be started. Yeah, you see pictures of on the left, a trial. All the trials are with a grower. A trial in West Vlaanderen with Dirk van Parijs, here in the Pfalz in Germany, here in Lincolnshire with Chris, here in Spain, in Cadiz, in the south of Spain, and here in a trial in Poland near Warsaw. So all the trials are the most trials are in Europe, because that's the big market. We put the trials in the where the leek is grown. For example, here in France, a lot of leeks is grown in Normandy and in the Loire Valley. So you see that also the trials are concentrated there. There's also a big concentration in Holland, but that is where our trial station is located. And actually, we are in the middle of a leek area. Also, we have trials, for example, in Warsaw, near Poland. You have already seen a picture of that. And also, for example, in a difficult climate like Segovia in Spain. Segovia is on a sea level of 800 meters. The summers are really hot and a lot of trips pressure. And the autumn and winter, it can get cold in the night, and the day temperature can rise up till 20 degrees. So, and it's nice to test our new hybrids on this climate like that. Future developments. We have a nice package of leek varieties from summer till winter, but for the overwinter, we're still looking for a nice one. And it must be for own overwinter variety. We are looking for a slow bolting variety. And here you see a picture. So the flower must be the development of the flower must be slow. Also, we're looking for a Lincoln hybrid, and Bulgarian type. Also, we want to use speed breeding in a phytotron to make for special characters to make the breeding faster. We hope to do the cycle in 1 year. Normally, it takes 2 years, and now we have a cycle of 1 year. Also, we looking for a new male sterile system. It's called cytoplasmatic male system. It's easier to produce the hybrids, and it will make the hybrid even more uniform. Also, we're going to use markers. And also, we are working together with the University of Wageningen on TRIPS resistance. And therefore, we made already a crossing between Allium eduardi, is a wild relative of leek, and that one is TRIPS resistant. We crossed it with leek, a normal leek, and here you see the picture in the middle, the plant. This one is TRIPS resistant, but it doesn't look like leek, so we have to make back crossings to maintain, to keep the TRIPS resistant and the appearance of a normal leek. Leek is a very nice product, I think. It's also healthy, a lot of vitamins in it, A, B, C. It's good, for example, against obesitas, and it's good for your veins. It's versatile. You can use it in many dishes, like empanadas, in a pie, in soups, of course, but also in salads. So it's very versatile. And it is sustainable. You can grow it in most every climate, or most countries you can grow a leek quite easy. There's no plastic involved. Also, in packaging in the supermarket, you can sell your leeks just without a package. And you can grow it year-round in most countries. And don't forget, leek is really delicious. So that's it. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Peter, for a very interesting presentation. I want to ask to the audience if there are any questions about your presentation. If you have any questions, please add them in the chat. A lot of positive remarks are passing by, Peter, so that is that is good to hear.
Maybe it's clear. Yeah.
We have one question.
Oh, okay.
The question is, Peter, what hybrids do you recommend for direct sowing?
Yeah, we have we have two for dry for direct sowing. You need longer. You need a hybrid that it's make longer shanks, because the shank lengths will be short in a direct drilling. And Batter and Climber are really nice varieties for that purpose.
Okay, thank you. We have one more question. Is it harder to breed over winter varieties than other types?
Yes, it's harder, but also it has to do when the bolting is slow. Yeah, also can have some problems in seed production, so that's it makes it more difficult.
Yeah, it has two sides.
But,
then one more question from our colleague Dennis.
Yeah,
he's interested in the Bulgarian types.
Yeah, well, it will take a few years for sure to, and especially to develop the borderline. So, but we have already I've already Walker F1, and that's I would say it's not really a Bulgarian giant, but it's a type in between. So, and Walker has also a very long shank already, but not that long as Lincoln, but. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. We have a question from Matej. He is asking about which varieties can be recommended for overwintering production. I think good to add that this is really depending on which country you are located, and good to discuss that with the local sales representative to get more advice on that. And we have a question from Hendrik. We see more and more problems with the Allium leaf miner. Do you think there will be any resistance for that, Peter? Or?
Yeah, we try to select all, but we see the problem is there is no big differences between the varieties, so it will be a difficult task for us.
Okay. Then one last question before we go to the next topic. Is it already understood why this Allium species is resistant against trips?
No. That's a good question. We don't know yet.
Okay. Then I want to thank you, Peter, for your presentation. Very informative. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
We will continue to the next subject. We will have a look at a video about plant raising of leeks. If you want to work, if you are going to work with hybrids, uniformity is one of the added values of hybrids, but this already starts with the production of young plants. In this video, we will have a look on how the young plants are produced in the professional plant raiser in the Netherlands, in the village near.
In Western Europe, leek plants are mostly produced by specialized plant raisers. In this video, we will have a look at the young plant production in the Netherlands at one of these professional plant raisers.
Hi, my name is John Beren from Beren Plant Products. I'm the third generation plant grower in Neer, the Netherlands. Our company grows asparagus crowns, strawberry plants, and also leek plants. And we are lifting and supplying leek plants all over Europe at the moment. We supply professional growers in Europe.
Before the growing season starts, soil analyses are made to check the status of the soil. Based on the results, the fertilization plan can be made. To guarantee a good start of the growing of the leek plants, the circumstances have been optimized. At the start of the sowing season, the soil is prepared by a cultivator. This is done at a depth of approximately 40 to 60 centimeters to break up layers and to open up the soil to dry. In the next step to prepare the soil, a rotating spade machine is used. The machine inserts oxygen in the soil, breaks big clots, and creates a nice flat soil structure, almost ready for sowing. Now the beds are created, fertilizer is spread on the soil in front of the tractor. In the first stage of the germination, when the leek plants don't need much fertilizer, a basic mixture is used. The machine behind the tractor prepares the beds. The soil is now ready for sowing.
We are here in the south of the Netherlands, in one of the fields of the company Beren Plant Products. Today we will have a look at the soil preparation and the drilling of the leek seeds.
Most of the plants that are produced by Beren Plant Products are ordered by growers before the growing season starts. The planning of the sowing is based on the delivery of the leek plants. The vacuum sowing machine is currently sowing 6 lines on a bed of 1.5 meters wide. The depth of sowing is approximately 1 to 2 centimeters, depending on the weather forecast and the moisture in the soil. Using this system, Beren Plant Products is sowing around 4 to 5 million seeds per hectare. The pressing wheels on the sowing machine make sure the soil on top of the seeds is pressed so it stays moist. To make sure it contains enough moisture for germination, the soil is irrigated. Afterwards, the soil is covered with plastic and acrylic to protect it against cold temperatures at night and to prevent it from being blown away. The first plantings are covered by plastic tunnels to protect them against the cold spring nights. This will speed up the germination and prevents the bolting of the leeks. Bolting can appear during stress periods in the growing season. This can be caused by cold nights, but also by dry periods in the growing season. When the soil is too dry, the chance of bolters during cold night increases. When the soil is sufficiently moist, the risk of boltering is lower. Plastic tunnels are used to be able to deliver ready leek plants from week 22 to 24. Here you can see the Bijo hybrid curling, which is sown on the 24th of February. Later sowings, like on this field sown on March 29th, are covered with plastic and acrylic. Sprinkler irrigation is placed in the field so irrigation can take place when necessary.
It's the middle of June. We are back in the field to have a look on how the plants have developed. We will also see the leek plant harvest.
The tops of the leek plants are cut a few times. This provides more light for smaller plants, which ensures a more uniform result. Just before the harvest, the plants are being cut one more time. This action will stimulate the growth after transplanting, and it makes it easier to transport the plants in plastic crates. Approximately 12 weeks after sowing, the leek plants are ready for harvest and can be delivered to the leek growers.
We are at one of our nursery fields with leek plants. We are full in the leek delivery season at the moment. And to have a good quality leek plant, uniformity is an important thing. Of course, the plants need to be free of diseases and insects. And the root structure is an important thing to have a good start of your leek production.
The plants are harvested by a belt lifter, which has sufficient capacity and operates without damaging the leek plants. Here you can see the nicely developed roots of the leek plants. The plants are placed vertically in the plastic crates so they can be transported straight. The end result shows perfect uniform plants. Plants are collected in plastic crates and stacked on pallets to transport them to the cool storage. The plants are brought to the cool storage directly from the field to make sure they don't lose moisture. Thanks to good planning and organization, Beren Plant Products is able to deliver quality leek plants to their customers in the requested week of the year.
So in this video is shown how professional plant raisers are producing perfect uniform leek plants, which are ready to be delivered to the growers. We'll continue to have a look on a video how the plants from the plant raiser are delivered to the grower, and you will have a look at the cultivation of the leek plants.
Let's look at how leeks are grown on René Klaas's farm. His company specializes in leek cultivation. It's located in the southern Netherlands. Here, the crop is grown mainly on sandy soils. Leeks grow best in soil with a pH level between 5.7 and 6. Klaas grows leeks for the fresh market and for industry. He supplies all his vegetables under production contracts. The fresh market produce is sold to supermarkets. Plants are delivered from the nursery and transplanted in the field. This is done from late February until early August. The precise start date depends on weather conditions. When there's a chance of night frost, the leeks are covered with acrylic to keep them from bolting. This planting window allows leeks to be delivered to the market all year long. Klaas grows different varieties for summer, autumn and winter. Before planting, the soil is analyzed for nutrients and the presence of nematodes. The results are used to make a fertilization plan. The plants are fertilized with a total of 70 kg of pure nitrogen and 100 kg of potassium. Granulate fertilizer or animal manure can be used. A planting machine places all the leeks at the same depth, evenly spaced. A pressure wheel ensures that the plant's roots make contact with the soil and that the soil stays moist. The machine plants 5 rows at a time. Rows are 60 centimeters apart. On this field, leeks are planted at 180,000 plants per hectare. The distance between plants in each row is approximately 10 centimeters. Planting depth depends on market demand. When a longer wide shank is desired, leeks are planted deeper in the soil. In general, for summer plantings, the depth is 5 to 10 centimeters. For autumn plantings, it's 10 to 15 centimeters. Summer plantings are planted more shallowly to encourage faster growth. For plantings deeper than 15 centimeters, the leeks are placed in holes that have been poked in the soil. After planting, the leeks are irrigated to ensure they'll start growing immediately. The aim is to achieve stable growth throughout the season, resulting in the best quality product. Irrigation and fertilization need to take place at exactly the right moment to create optimal growing conditions. A vacuum spreader is used to fertilize between rows. This prevents the fertilizer from burning the shanks of the plants. During the growing season, mechanical weed control is used to eliminate unwanted plants and add oxygen to the soil. These leeks have reached their marketable size and are ready for harvest. The requested diameter is between 2 and 4 centimeters. Using hybrids allows a grower to achieve perfect uniformity at the requested size, as René Klaassen shows us here. The crop is harvested using a belt lifter. First, the rollers lift the bottom leaves. The top of the leaves are cut off. Then a belt takes the leeks out of the soil and transports them to the top of the machine, where they are dropped on the horizontal belt. The belt drops the leeks into the containers horizontally. When the leeks are uniform, the belt lifter will operate smoothly. Labor is one of the biggest costs in leek production. With this machine, two people can do the harvesting. The average yield is between 50 and 60 tons per hectare. René Klaassen harvests fresh leeks every day. When rainy or cold weather is expected, more leeks are harvested and placed in storage. For short storage periods, the leeks are kept at 4 degrees Celsius. For longer storage, the temperature is -1. The plants don't freeze at these temperatures. They stay fresh and can remain in storage for 4 to 6 weeks. Before being delivered to the customer, the leeks are washed, peeled, and sorted. They're taken out of the containers and placed on the belt of the processing line. First, the roots are removed and the leaves are cut to the same length. The vegetables are washed and then peeled. Hybrid varieties are selected for quick and easy peeling. The leeks are packed in the plastic crates, wooden boxes, or carton boxes, depending on the customer's preference. Using hybrids results in good yields, optimum efficiency, a uniform product, and perfect quality.
So with these two videos, this gave the full overview of the production of young plants up till the end product. I see we received one question from Matej from Croatia, asking about growing leeks with direct sowing instead of transplanting to save the costs of production of seedlings. This is a possibility, direct sowing, but there are a lot of challenges with that, with weed control and also the uniformity during germination. That is why this transplanting way is used. We continue the program to we go to the presentation of Daniela. Daniela will tell us more about leek further in the chain. Daniela, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, René. I'm Daniela, Food and Value Chain Manager at Bayo. One of my personal ambitions is bringing change to the produce shelves, tempting consumers to eat more vegetables by inspiring them and offering them good, healthy concepts and varieties, and by providing them also the right information on the shelves. In that case, I follow news about food trends and personalized foods with great interest. We already heard a lot about the added value of leek hybrids, the cultivation, but also about the breeding parts and the breeding goals we have. I like to give you some more insights in the way how it is marketed in Europe, the USA, and some East European countries. So I will tell a bit more about the general information and some highlights. a short overview about health and taste, a fresh and industry market overview per country, some developments in leek, a small part about the market and consumer trends and the opportunities leek can offer you. Well, if we look at the general information and some highlights in leek, well, in Western Europe, it's quite a major traditional and sometimes a bit an old-fashioned vegetables. We do see some changes in the market from packed to short leeks and loose, but also still some in packagings. So sold by the piece also a lot. In Eastern Europe countries like Belarus and Russia, it's quite a new crop and we see it growing in popularity as well. That results that the market in Western Europe is stable and we see increase in Eastern Europe. If we look to some consumer behavior that changed during the COVID pandemic, more nutritious and more daily fresh vegetables are used. To give an example, research shows that 4 out of 10 Dutch persons are cooking differently than before. So there are some developments going on. And in the period of end of February till the end of March, compared to last year, 51% more leek is sold in the Dutch supermarkets. Next to that, online sales are exploding and consumers are buying more at a grower's place. So like home shops, where they can also give a bit of extra information and attention. Taste and health in leek. Well, Peter mentioned it already. Leek is very tasteful and also a healthy vegetable. It's a special vegetable with advantages. It has the next to the common nutrient folate and fibers. It also contains mineral manganese and iron. It's rich in vitamin K, vitamin C, but also a good source of dietary fiber and other minerals. Even the leaf tops are a good provider of beta-carotene, so like the carrots. So that's also why it is such a versatile product, because you can eat a complete leek. It's low in calories. It also lowers the risk on chronic diseases. And even the dark green part of the leeks contain the most vitamins and minerals. And leek has a light onion taste and nice spicy vegetables with a pleasant aroma. So it's a very versatile vegetable, which can be used in many ways. Then we go further to the market overview. Every market wants different leeks, as Peter explained already. We give an overview of some of the countries, how they are presenting in their market. But first, something about the availability. Leek is mostly year-round available in all the countries, not always produced in all countries in the same period. So some of the countries are also importing, like Germany from the Netherlands and Germany, Denmark from the Netherlands and Spain, the UK from Spain. Also Poland is importing some of the leeks, even from Turkey, for example. And so you see some differences in the availability. In some of the countries, it's mainly a winter product and more seasonal, but you see some changes about year-round consumption. For a few of the markets, also the regional availability is very important. Like in Germany, for example. In Germany, they also have a very constant consumption. Although that is 1.5 kilo per head, although that's very low compared to, for example, tomatoes, which are much more used. But yeah, as it is a versatile product, which you can use in a lot of dishes as an ingredient, it is used. But we think that with new recipes and new ideas, consumption can be enlarged. In France, the market is divided about 75% fresh and 25% frozen in terms of the purchase frequency. However, in France, one-fifth never buys a leek. So some of them don't like it, some of them don't think about it, or some don't know how to prepare, or they think it's too long to prepare. and to change the situation, producer associations push to promote the early types with the tender fibers and shorten cooking times due to the tenderness. And they also promote the new packagings with ready-to-cook white leeks. And even frozen leek products are not always considered as an alternative, the prepared ones. So for Denmark, eaten during autumn and winter time, fresh and local mainly. In Belgium, you see a lot of flow packs, but also they have a lot of brands in Belgium about a leek, so they can really promote a leek brand. Mostly used in soups, but also in a lot of other dishes and ingredients. In the UK, they have a specific promotion on website, which is called British Leeks, which they give a lot of information. They have ambassadors. They keep up with all the things in the market. Growers are interviewed. It's also educational way. Fun facts are over there as well. So really a great way to promote leeks on their market. And especially in the UK, they like a lot of white, not that much green, and with a long white shank. In Spain, it's different from different production areas it's available, and sometimes in wintertime they import because of the price. And I find it quite an expensive product to be used as an ingredient, and they rather do some other ingredients. In Poland, it's very popular, and also the industry is using it in different purposes, mainly used in soups and fresh salads. In Southeast Europe, which is more the Balkan countries, it's a bit less available in summertime, but the market is growing every year. In Belarus, they need import from November to August. The consumption is raising and increasing. Raw in salads or boils, and often add to meat. And in Russia, the situation is changing every year, but they see great growth potential. And leeks are used for making soups, casseroles, cakes even, and fresh salads. And also the consumption over there is increasing the last years. We will now have a short overview per country from the fresh market possibilities. Like in Germany, you see a lot of different items. You see them loose in boxes, especially in retail, in the markets and in the farmer shops. But you also see some flow packs at, for example, Lidl or Aldi. You also see cartons with foil, some bunches, and also in soup it's used. Fresh cut as convenience product and also cut as frozen products. For France, I already told you about the consumption, 75% fresh, 25% frozen. As a volume, they think it's about 80% fresh and 20% frozen. Almost 75% is bought fresh in the supermarket, but also in the short chain, so at the farm shops itself. There is also a large organic market in France, so the differentiation is about 70-30%, and very few parts are packed only for the white part, which is a large mega trend in France, is the zero residue, the pesticides, so they really marketed that, and they have a marketing campaign behind that, as you can see also on the image, and they try to attract consumers to buy leek by this trend. In Denmark, it's primarily offered in packages of 3 or 4, or in loose, where you can buy by the piece or sold by piece. And it also limits the food waste and a lot of focus on that. So by buying exactly what you would like to have, we are able to limit also the food waste, which is a huge trend nowadays as well. One of the most important growing areas in the European Union is Belgium. It's a large growing area, and you see there more and more short leeks. You see it in flow packs, but also loose, by the way, to buy the piece. You see here a nice package with the brand Fine Fleur, which is a Belgian brand of super quality. So they really market the product, and also they really market the product by locality, so grown in their own country. So all the products are often sold also with a Belgian flag on it. So they are well prepared for the market. And also you see it, of course, at outside markets and farmer shops. But then it's mainly loose or bunches. If we look at another item for Belgium, they're packing it for the auction. And there you have the Belgian brand Flandria, which is also a good quality brand. And it's especially made by farmers of the Leek farm. Some other Western Europe countries, in the UK, usually loose in farm shops, sometimes pre-packed 2-3 leeks in supermarkets. In Spain, you also see it in small shops, loose by weight, but also in trays of 3 leeks, or by weight, or in bunches. So you see a lot of different items. And in Poland, the main sale is also loose leeks in boxes. And the customer can also buy one or more pieces, and sometimes even packed as a flow pack. What is very popular in Poland as well is that they use it in mixtures of several vegetables, ready for soup. So you can buy a complete package where other items are in. We will show a picture later on. From Western Europe, we go to the US. Some of the same items, but they have also available sliced leek. They really market organic leek. They have leeks which are washed and ready to use, ready in a nice flow pack. And of course, it's also especially mentioned in soups, baby foods, or Asian style frozen mixes, which you see a lot of them in the marketplace. Leek is not as popular as other large vegetables like lettuce or spinach or carrot or onion. But also in the US, they start to discover the crop, and they are seeing some increase in that. Southeast Europe is mainly Romania, Bulgaria, and the Balkan countries. They use a typical Bulgarian as a standard. It is used in soup, stew, quiches. Most popular is though the stew, and they like it with potatoes, but mainly used and sold fresh for cooking. And the market is also slightly growing every year. So as you can see on the images, it's mainly freshly presented. On the Belarusian market, we see some more combinations, like the frozen ones with various vegetables in the mix, but also fresh and fresh vacuum packed, or even packed only the long white shank, as you can see over here. And in Russia, about 80% is sold in supermarkets, and 90 by the piece, and 10 as sliced. Also, some sales are done in the local markets, still more seasonal. But there is a growing interest from consumers, and that's also because more of the favorable price for goods of Russian producers compared to import. And we see also some changes in the nutritional culture of Russian citizens and the development of a healthy diet. So we are witnessing an increase in interest in some vegetables, including leek. And the quality of the products in the country is significantly higher. And again, used both in fresh and frozen, and also in dried spices. And they see also the need for leeks which form a long white part and are sustainable for long-term storage. Here we show you some examples of the Russian retail and supermarket shelves, where you can see how leek is presented. Some impressions of the fresh market, where you can see in the left top some nice bunches of the early leeks. Here you see some, on the left bottom, you see some leeks packed in nets, which are mainly delivered then for wholesale or processing. And next to that, you see also some nice bunches in the supermarkets, which are either by 3 or 5 all the same size, the same shank length, etc. And also loose in crates, how they are presented. Some impression of combined with other vegetables, which is mainly done in Poland and also in some other countries, where you can have all the products together and actually you're ready to cook. So the mixed vegetable contains a nice cleaned leek already, and then the other ones you have still the fresh feeling of the bottom of the leek included. If you look at the industry, yes, Peter explained already, industry and processing industry, processing partners need long shanks for the processing. So in that case, you get nicely leek rings, which are often cut as a fresh produce, cut and made in vegetable with other processed vegetables, but also frozen. As you can see a lot of examples over here. You have some low-cost frozen leek, but also some more sophisticated, already prepared, so you only have to put it in the pan. But you have a lot of different items in the frozen industry which can be easily used for the convenience of the consumer. Well, how do you keep leek fresh if you have bought it once and at a consumer's place? Well, if you have it entire leek, you can keep it in the fridge for about 10 days, wash and cut. That's only about 5-6 days, not washed, but in a fresh and humid area for 1 to 2 months. And if you have packed leek, you can keep it in the fresh either. And if you see a nice package, which you see over here, that has of course somewhat smaller shelf life. Well, then the uses of leek. Also, Peter ended his presentation already with this. Leek is very versatile. You can use it in many items, stir fries, baking. The whole leek is edible, as I mentioned before. And so it is easy as a main dish, as a garnish, but also an elegant side. Examples are soups, roast, mash or layers, even noodles, stews, quiches. Actually, everything you can think of can be made with it. And so a very, very nice product with a lot of opportunities for the market. If we look at the current market and consumer trends, we see in the consumer part that we have some items like localism, also support your local growers. We have some new channels like online ordering, meal kits, where are a lot of possibilities. Healthy recipe box are in that as well. Also good for organic production, produced vegetables. Well, it's a fresh and healthy vegetable, of course. Home cooking, as explained earlier, is very popular. Convenience is easy. Food safety is an issue where we can think of, and even snacking and on the go. So more and more vegetables eating. Some new flavors, nutritional personalized food, like you have the developments in protein, vegan. Also leek can have a possibility in that case. The food waste, which is already mentioned, sustainable, ethical, environmental friendly and transparent, and changing demographics. And then market trends is that we see an increasing vegetable consumption, still not the way we would like to have it, but the increased usage of vegetables can be done during a lot of other eating times than only the dinner, so also during lunchtime or even at breakfast, and that should go up even, and the increase is also in pre-cut vegetables. We see a digitization of the food retail, food as a service, the home deliveries, food as an experience, so really experience it, all the innovations which are going on. Some new farming systems are along. The lack of labor of medical harvesting. We already saw in the presentations that we have some nice mechanical harvesters. And shortening the food chain is also one of the market trends where we can think about. If we look then at the opportunities for leek, It really is a focus for inspire and inform the consumer and really look at the market from their point of view. What do they want to do with the leak and where can they use it for? Get them a lot of knowledge. So new recipes in new cuisine looks and generate new ideas. The local item is a very good opportunity. More input about healthiness, more knowledge about that. Try out different packaging types, smaller packaging, smaller baby leaks, different way of marketing the leaks. And there are some new ideas necessary to increase the consumption. But at the end, it's still popular on the fresh market. And that's where I wanted to end. And I hope with this presentation, I give you a bit of an overview of how the market looks like and what kind of possibilities there are for growers to grow leek and especially the hybrids with an added value. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Daniela, for a very interesting presentation on how to use leek further in the chain. And we come to an end of our presentation. As a conclusion, there's still a big potential for leek in several markets. There are a lot of developments going on in different kind of packings, making quality brands in the market, but also in organic, what is a growing trend in many countries. Then bio leek breeding. Peter gave an interesting presentation about developments in our breeding program, the characteristics and where they are breeding on, and developments and what we can expect in the coming time. We got a view on the advantages of hybrid varieties compared to open pollinated varieties. And Daniela told us about the possibilities with leek further in the chain. First of all, I would like to thank you, all the participants, for joining this online event. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Daniela, for giving the presentation. And working together on the preparations. I want to wish you all a good evening, a good morning, and a good afternoon from which part of the world you are joining. I want to thank you all, and we keep in touch.